Jesus. On the last verse, we're coming over for all we pray.
Sister Lord. is all missing part.
That's wrong. God bless.
I'd like to say I thank God for being here now. Thank him for all he's done for me and thank him for the service that we had. So I know we still help him. I like this church. Remember the lady I keep, you know, she told me yesterday, I went in there and she was there with me and she looked at me and she said, I wish I could go to heaven. And said, I'd like to take my kids with me. And I told her, I said, you know, honey, you're going to go to heaven. When it comes your turn, you'll be going. And today she's not done good at all.
That's your bad. That's me.
Like I said, it's good to be safe.
Yes, it is. She's here.
I'd just like to thank her for all my many blessings and thank her for the warm church to come into and the great spirit I can feel when I come in here. Get out of the world for just a little bit and be able to just come here in his house and worship him.
Amen.
Just thankful for that.
Amen. Bless you, John.
Bless him, Lord.
Oh, I don't remember my uncle, Mom. He told me today and he was cancer-free in August. He's come back and did his lungs and stage four.
Bless you, Sharon.
We talked. You know, the main thing is he's ready to go. And it's still going to break, keep from breaking my heart. And he's that sick. I mean, he may get rid of it again. I don't know. I'm not God. But I just want everybody to remember and pray.
Bless you, Sharon. Do you remember this request?
Marty, it's good to be here tonight. Most of all, it's good to be safe. Now, you know, I don't normally do this, but I've got a decision I got to make at work, and I'd like for y'all to help me pray. I'd make the right one. I know what I want to do. I just want to do what God wants.
Bless you, guys. God bless your heart.
Thank God for being here tonight, being back. I asked him to remember the church we went to same night. We just need a lot of prayers.
Amen.
Get another opportunity to go this next Sunday night, Derek gets the opportunity to preach. If Lord be the Lord's will, maybe we can do something to help that church. I just thank God for the church that I'm a member of, for the freedom and spirit and love that's here. You know, Jonathan talked about when you walk in the door, you can feel it.
Yeah.
I started feeling it on the way here, and I thank God for that. The day I got an opportunity to drive to Maryville and had to deliver some stuff and was listening to some gospel music, and I heard a song, and it said that if you've got pain, he's the pain taker. If you've got it, man, you're lost, he's the way maker. Bound chains, he's a chain breaker.
Yes.
I'm glad tonight to know that whatever I face, he can handle it for me. No matter what it is, no matter how little or how big it is, my God can take care of it tonight. I'm thankful for that. Ashley's a member, Robbie. She's having surgery Friday. Knowing that the natural man is just a little worried.
Oh, yeah.
But there's a deep, subtle peace inside that knows that no matter what I already said, no matter what it is, my God can take care of it. I know that I can't go back there with her, but I have a Heavenly Father that can go back there and he can hold her hand.
Oh,
and I'm glad of that tonight. No matter where we're at, we may seem like we're all alone, but I've got a God that can hold my hand. You know, it was just me and him in that tree. truck today, but it will help with the door for it was to go. And then it was me and him. And then no matter where I'm at, he's with me. Because then that Sunday morning where I knelt down, he promised me he'd never leave me nor forsake me. And I know that he's going to take care of me. Just ask him to be with us and remember us that I'd be found doing what God has to me. And that Sunday morning, I had to come up here, and I had to get a little closer to him. You preached about being in the hog pen. I wasn't in the hog pen, but I was headed that way. And the Lord showed me that, and I'm glad that I could leave it there, and he could take care of it for me. And I'm glad that I have a church that... And if I have to come every service, they're not going to talk about me. They're going to pray for me. They're going to lift my name up. And I don't have to worry about coming in here and going to that altar. And I know you guys are praying for me. I'm glad to know that I'm a member of this church. I've said before, this is probably the fifth church I've been a member of. But I'm thankful most of all for being a member here. More important than that, I know that my name's recorded up in heaven. And ain't nobody can touch that. This church wrote one day. Is going to burn up. As much as we love this place, it's going to burn up. But that's written down in glory. Nobody can touch that. And I'm glad to know that my name's there. And that I know, as Sean said, Sunday morning, I know that I know that I know. And I may lose my mind one day, but I'll never be able to lose that feeling. I'll never be able to lose that moment, that hard road. I believe that with all my heart. And that I'll know that I've passed from death into life. Because now he's not in my mind.
Right.
He's in my heart. I'm glad to know that he's there tonight.
Bless him, boy.
I just want to share this. And I had a feeling on the way here. It was the same feeling I had the night that Chloe got saved. And I didn't know that night that she was going to get saved. But I had a feeling that something good was going to happen. And on the way here, I had the same feeling. And I thank God for that. So it may be a Wednesday night. But let's just turn loose tonight.
Amen,
and see what God has in store. That same night that Chloe got saved, we all came together in one mind and one accord. Everybody was willing to do their little part. And because of that, God passed by her way and she answered that. My heart's desire tonight is that God would pass by somebody else tonight. One of those that we've been praying for. Maybe somebody that we don't even know of. Maybe that tonight you're a member of Hilltop. But you're not a member of the church. It's time that you become a member of the church. No matter what it is tonight, if God's dealing with you, you need to come to this altar. Let's just do what God would have us to. That has already been said. We had a good service Sunday. But those services are past and gone. God's the same tonight. And the only thing that changes is us. And our desire to be willing to do what he'd have us to. If Marty and Dad hadn't got up and been willing to preach this message Sunday morning, I thought of us probably wouldn't be able to come and get renewed up. And I'm thankful tonight that I have a pastor that'll preach on me. He'll tell me when I'm wrong. I don't need any pat on the back. I need to know when I'm wrong. Because of that, not only that, but it shows me that I'm with God. Because if I was lost and I was out doing whatever, I'd be okay with that. I'm saved tonight.
Yes,
if I'm wrong, I need to know that. And the Lord will show me. Whether it be just that, just show me. Or sometimes a man of God has to get up and preach to us. We need that. So let's just have church tonight and see what God would have in store for us. I'd love to see one of these that I've been praying for. Come and then man will get saved. I'd love to see some stranger come to that back door and be saved. It don't matter to me. I just want a new brother or a new sister tonight. Let's just turn loose and see what God has in store. I don't want to take over, but if the Lord's laid a song on your heart, sing it tonight. Maybe you've never sung in church before. Sing it tonight for God. Because of that, you may be salvation. Marty said it Sunday morning. It takes somebody to turn that key. Let's just see. If God's telling you to turn the key, might turn it. It might mean salvation for somebody. And this could be, we don't know, this could be the last opportunity we have to meet here. And I want to make the best of it. I want to praise him tonight because he's worthy of that praise. He deserves it tonight.
Thank you, Lord.
Because he's done so much for me. I told him that Sunday night down there, I got to see my wife in that shade and got to baptize her. I got to see my little girl saved and baptize her. I got to see Trent saved and baptize him. Why is that? Because God saw fit to bless me. He just saw fit to bless me. Why did he see fit to bless me? I don't know. Because I'm nothing tonight.
Keep us there.
One Sunday morning, and he made me something. I heard another song today. It ain't because of who I am, but because of what he's done.
Amen.
Not because of what I've done, but because of who he is.
Right.
Think about that tonight. We're nothing tonight. We're just in that filthy
dirt.
We're just in that dirt.
Yeah.
But through God, we're a child of the King. Through the blood of
Listen,
the Lamb, we're a child of the King. That's what he wants you to be tonight.
Amen.
He's been dealing with you for a long time.
Oh,
somebody here tonight is lost. It needs to be saved.
Listen,
it's time that
Let's
you get out there.
Yeah, come
and
on,
then you've been down.
Come on, boy.
As I already said, he's a chain breaker.
Yeah,
and that
yeah.
Sunday morning, I was bound down with sin. I was bound down on my way to the devil's hell. But then he came by, and he said, I want to save you. And you know what he did? He saved me because I was willing to give it all to him.
Yeah,
and that's all that you have to be tonight. It's just be willing and say, Lord, here am I. Just save me. That's all that I did. I didn't do nothing else. I wasn't that beside no card. I didn't have to shake the preacher's hand.
No,
I didn't have to have any money in my pocket.
On,
because if it cost it, there wouldn't be enough money in the world.
Bless you, Mark. Come on,
Trey. And then they have a credit card. It says this costs this much.
Yeah.
This costs this much. And at the end, it says this is priceless.
On,
the blood of the Lamb is priceless.
Amen.
Blood. And the price has already been paid for when he hung on Calvary.
Bless
and he
Lord.
Said, I've done it for you.
Amen.
And he said, Father, into my hands I commend my spirit. It was paid for.
Yeah.
And they took him off that cross.
Bless
and they laid him in a borrowed tomb. Why was the tomb borrowed? Because he only needed it for 3 days. And after those 3 days, he came out of there victorious over death, hell, and the grave.
Amen.
And because of his victory,
yeah.
I have victory.
Yeah.
And you can have the same victory tonight. And they sang a song, Victory in Jesus. You can have that victory in Jesus tonight.
Yeah.
All you got to do is be willing to step out.
Yeah.
And that's all that I'm doing right
Let's
now. It's just stepping out. And that's all the Lord wants you to do.
Amen.
Yeah.
I'm telling you right now. Right now, I feel pretty good. And because I stepped out on faith. Just because I was willing to step out on faith. The Lord said, I started blessing me and it started coming more and more. And now, look, the Bible says you get out there and you're ankle deep.
Yeah.
You get out there and you're about your waist.
Uh-huh.
And then you get out there and you can swim. I'm about to get out there where I can swim. So why don't you just come on and get out there and
Bless
step
you.
In the water
yeah.
and see how good it is. I'm telling you tonight, it'll be good for you.
Amen.
You'll never have to worry about hell again.
No.
I've said it before. That Sunday morning when I knelt down and I asked the Lord to save me, I've never had a fear of hell. And Satan's trying to make me doubt it and try to tell me I didn't have it. But still during that time, I never feared hell. Because there was a deep subtle peace set inside of me. And that's all the Lord's wanting to do for you tonight.
It's
set that deep subtle peace inside so that you can have life and have it more abundantly.
Yeah.
You say, what does that mean? He wants you to enjoy life.
Yeah.
And you think you're enjoying life now.
Right.
And I'm telling you, once you get a hold of him, once he becomes your Savior and your friend, then you'll really know how about living life.
Yeah.
Because you don't have to worry about death. Right now, as you're lost, you have to worry about death.
Bless him, Lord.
Because if death finds you right now, hell will be your home. And there ain't no way around it. That's just the truth. It's the blood truth. And that's all you need to hear tonight. And that hell will be your home if you die in the condition you're in. But if you now accept him tonight, you won't have to worry about dying again.
No more.
All of us are going to face death.
Bless him, Lord.
Every one of us is going to shed this old earthly form. But I don't fear that.
No.
I fear what I have to do and what I have to face to get to that point because of my wrongdoings.
Yeah,
but I don't have to worry about death ever again. Because once I close these eyes and just go to sleep, I'll be woke up at the foot of the Lamb. I'll be there with Jesus. And you can do the same thing tonight.
Listen,
and you just turn loose.
Listen, Lord.
And just let God.
Amen.
Just turn loose.
Listen,
and just go with God.
Listen.
And there ain't no other way to get to heaven.
No,
there ain't tell you that you can do this or you can do that.
Come on,
but there's only one way to get to heaven. It's through it by the blood of the Lamb.
Amen.
The only way to have that applied is first you have to know that you're lost.
Yeah.
And I believe right now you know that.
Right.
I believe right now there's somebody here tonight that knows that they're lost. And they're scared to death right now. But that you don't have to be scared anymore. Or you can just turn loose and just let God and that just save you.
Yeah.
Just let Him save you tonight.
Yeah.
That's all He's wanting to do.
Yeah.
That's why we've gathered here tonight.
Yeah.
Is to worship Him and to give Him the praise and honor and glory He deserves and to see you saved.
Amen.
Bless you more.
And as Dustin preached tonight, Sunday night, why did you come? Why did you come to church? Was it just to be a bench warmer?
Bless
or was it
Lord.
To praise the name of God? I
yeah.
come tonight to praise His name,
yes.
not because He's
yes.
worthy of
Bless
it, but because that He saved me.
Yeah.
He saved my household. And not only that, He's done a lot between those things.
Yes.
He's woke me up this morning in my right mind.
Yeah.
He's put the clothes on my back.
Bless
He gave me a vehicle to drive, the job that I have. He's gave me the
bless
church to come to.
Yes.
He gave me all this. And He's wanting to bless you tonight.
Bless
you
more.
Say, what
do
I got to do?
Come on, Travis.
Just right now, He's knocking. He's knocking. He's wanting in. He's wanting in there.
Yeah.
He is wanting in there. All you got to do is open up your heart and say, here, my Lord, make me what you have me to be. I know that I'm nothing, and I don't want anything but you just to save me.
Bless you, Father.
You just got to come humble tonight.
Yeah.
That's all that I did.
Uh-huh.
I start off in the back of the church. You've all heard this before.
Uh-huh.
But I'm going to tell you again.
Uh-huh.
And then I start off in the back of the church. And I thought Mom could make it better. So I went and sat beside Mom. And then that feeling that I had didn't go away.
Uh-huh.
And I looked at Mom and I said, I need to go get saved.
Bless
and I knelt down. And this old natural mouth never opened up. But my heart cried out. And He said, Lord, I need a Savior.
Yeah.
And He came down right that moment. And He saved me.
Amen.
And that's what He'll do for you. If you just show Him that you're willing and just step out tonight, He'll take care of the rest.
That's right. Amen.
He's not going to force Himself on you tonight.
Come on, Travis.
He's not. But He wants to save you tonight. He wants you to be saved tonight. That's why He gave up heaven.
Yeah.
There was a search went out, and there was nothing found. No one found.
No.
But He said, Father, I'll go, and I'll be in that pig hole. I'll be cussed. I'll not even have a place to lay my head. I'll go and be crucified. I'll go and let my own people reject me.
Bless Him all.
So that Travis
the
and anybody else that would need to be anybody else that will accept me can be saved.
Bless
He and that did it for you tonight.
Yes,
he did it just so you right now can
Bless
be saved.
Yeah,
you say that was many years ago.
Bless
I believe with all my heart. He saw you tonight.
Yeah.
He knew that you needed a Savior. He knew that there was no other way
for you
to accept
Bless
to get to heaven. There was no other way.
Bless
so He said, Father, I'll go and I'll do this so that you can have a Savior.
Yeah, I'll be that
way.
Yeah.
I'll go and I'll be crucified, Father.
Yeah.
I'll go and I'll let Him take that whip and whip me. He never opened His mouth.
No.
Any of us, if they did it to us, we'd jump up from there and be mad and say, stop.
Right.
But He said,
please.
I believe in that.
Come on,
Father. He said that. They was whipping Him. Father, just let me take these lashings. The Bible don't say this, but this is just Travis thinking.
Right.
Let me take these lashes.
Come on, Travis.
Let him, the Lord just give me the strength. Let Him take these nails and drop them into my hands and
Bless
into my feet.
Lord,
let me have the strength to take the spear so that I can be I can be that Savior that they need.
Bless Him, Lord.
That's all He's wanting to do tonight is to be your Savior, to be your friend, to be whatever you stand in need of tonight.
Yeah.
He already said He can be whatever we need.
Yes.
He can be. If you're in pain tonight, He can take the pain away.
Amen.
If you're in fear tonight, He can take that fear away tonight. Everyone, that was every single person that's ever been saved had a fear of hell.
Yeah.
Every single one of us.
Exactly.
Because that's where you first know that you're lost. You have a fear of hell. You have a fear that of going to your room tonight. And mom and dad or whoever turned the light off. You're scared of the dark tonight. You're scared of being alone tonight. Let God take care of that fear. Let him in that. You're scared to get out those doors and know what you might have to face. Say, Lord, I don't want to die tonight because I know that if I do, I'm going to hell. Well, let God take care of that tonight.
Yes.
You don't have to worry about that fear. No. You don't ever have to worry about dying or going to hell again. This is eternal. Once God saves you, you're always saved. Ain't no man can take it from you.
Exactly
the government
right.
May take and make it a law where it's illegal for us to gather like we are tonight.
Bless
and that's
Lord.
Fine. Let them go. Because I believe that there's still enough people and they will gather together somewhere and praise his name. And if not, I can gather with just me and him and I can praise his name.
Amen.
But if they can't, they might be able to try to make a law that says it's illegal to be saved. They may say it's illegal to accept Jesus, but they cannot take Jesus out of my heart.
No,
that he is there and for all eternity.
Amen.
He is going to be there forever and ever.
Come on, boy.
But at the same time, if you die in the condition you're in, you're going to be in hell forever and ever.
Right.
Jesus said that there was a rich man.
Come on.
He closed his eyes, died, and lifted his eyes in hell.
Bless him, Lord.
That rich man is still there tonight.
Still there.
He is not going to get out of hell. Once you close your eyes in death,
bless him, Lord.
Your fate's sealed. There's nothing that anybody can do. Right now, we can pray for you. We can preach to you. We can cry out to God and say, Lord, please just have mercy on just a little longer. But once your eyes close in death, there's nothing else can be done for you.
Bless him, Lord.
You have sealed your fate by not accepting him. You're saying, Lord,
exactly
I would
right.
rather in that die and go to hell. By not accepting him tonight, that's what you're saying.
Bless him, Lord.
Because I believe that somebody, the Lord's dealing with you tonight. I don't know who you are.
Bless you, Travis.
I have an idea, but I don't know for sure. But you, the Lord, know who you are tonight.
Right.
You know that the Lord's dealing with you. I don't have to tell you that tonight.
No.
I knew that Sunday morning the Lord was dealing with me. I didn't have to ask Mom, Mom, is this Jesus talking to me?
No.
I knew it was.
Right.
And I knew that I needed to be saved. How do you know that? You were only 6 years old. Because God showed me. He showed me just enough that I need to know. He showed me that there was a hell and that I was headed that way. And if I didn't accept him, I would be there. That's all you have to know tonight. You don't have to know the whole Bible. I've been saved for 20-something years and still don't know the whole Bible. And never will know the whole Bible. But I know tonight that I'm saved. And I knew that if I died the condition I was in that Sunday morning, I would be in hell. But I accepted him.
Bless him, Lord.
And that's all that he's wanting you to do tonight is accept him. Just say, Father, I'm willing to step out.
Yes.
And just step out on faith. And I promise you, once you make the first step, and before you know it, you'll get up off the altar and you'll have a peace come over you and that you won't even be able to understand. I can't understand it. Sometimes the peace, but I know that it's Jesus. I know that it's him and that gave me that peace. And he's wanting to give you that peace tonight. He's wanting to be your Savior, a friend and guide tonight. He's wanting to be your everything. He can take care of you tonight.
Bless him, Lord.
So what are you going to do with it? I said this last time I preached and copied it off of Scott and I'm going to burn it again. You're not telling me no. You're telling Jesus no tonight. By sitting there and doing nothing, you say, well, I ain't hurting nobody.
Bless him, Lord.
I'm just sitting here. By sitting there knowing that God's dealing with you tonight, you're saying, no, Jesus. I don't want you in my heart. I'd rather have hell.
Mm-hmm.
that you don't have to do that. Satan is telling you, you don't need to go up there tonight. You got another opportunity Sunday. Don't listen to him.
Why not?
Satan, and that is a liar. He don't love you. He don't want you to be saved and go to heaven. I bet he don't want you to go to hell either, because he don't want you there.
Bless the Lord.
He just don't want you to accept Jesus.
No, he don't.
Jesus loves you tonight.
Yes, he does.
He loves you enough to stretch out his arms.
Bless the Lord.
And let them, and they didn't force his hands down. No matter what people may tell you, they did not force his hands down. He let them drive those nails into his hands and to his feet. He let them do that so that you could have for that salvation. But he didn't end it there.
Bless him.
He went and he let them bury him in the tomb. And for 3 days, he was in that tomb. He came out, as I already said, victorious. Victorious so that you could have life.
Yes.
He's wanting to give you that life tonight. You say, well, you already said we're all going to die. That's what they call it, but to me, it's just shedding this fleshly form and getting a new glorified body, because I'm going to live on, and I ain't going to have to worry about anything. I'm going to be in heaven with Jesus. I can say that tonight. If you're here tonight and you cannot say those words, if you cannot say right now, I know that I know that I know that if I die, heaven would be my home. If you cannot say those words, I invite you to come to this altar. Maybe you've just drifted too far from the shore, and you cannot feel the presence of God. It's time that you get back to Him. You may be the one that's standing in the way tonight. These little ones may be looking up to you and waiting for you to move.
Could be.
And if you're here tonight and you can say, I know that heaven will not be my home, I invite you to come and meet this man named Jesus. I invite you to come and meet him. Because in that one, as I already said, once you step out tonight, he'll carry the rest of the way. You just got to show him that you're willing. And once you show him you're willing, I don't know why, but that seems like all I preach anymore is just be willing. That's all he's wanting you to do tonight, though, is just be willing. If you're willing and able to step out on faith tonight. I promise you it's good. I didn't know that I was going to say all this, but I'm glad that I stood there and I just followed the Lord. And the more He gave me, I'm glad of that tonight. And that's the way it is going to be for you. Once you step out and you show the Lord you're willing, that next step's going to be easier. Because the Lord's going to take you by the hand and He's going to lead you and He's going to carry you to this altar. And once you get down there, you say, preacher, I don't know what to say. I didn't know what to say that Sunday morning, but God gave me the words to say. You cannot repeat a prayer after me because I don't know what your heart needs to cry out. But Jesus does.
Yes,
and
does.
Jesus will give you the words to say. I had a friend one time when he got saved, he told me all he said. He always heard that Jesus was standing at the door knocking.
Bless
all he said was, come in. Maybe that's all you have to say tonight is just come in. I don't know. But the Lord is wanting to come in tonight, and He's wanting to save you.
Bless
you. Maybe that you're scared tonight, and you don't want to come up this altar, and God said, that's okay, you don't have to come up here.
Bless you, Lord.
Just fall down where you're at. We'll gather around you, and we'll pray with you.
We will.
And you can be saved right where you're standing. You say, why? You said I had to step out. Stepping out might just be falling on your knees.
Bless you, Lord.
Stepping out might just be a bow in your head. We saw one stand right over here. He didn't move. All he did was cry out to God. That's all you got to do tonight.
Yeah.
That's what I mean by stepping out.
Yeah.
It's just crying out to Him.
Yeah.
He'll give you the words to say.
Yeah. Amen.
As far as the Lord wants me to go, the old saying, the ball's in your court now. What are you going to do with it?
Yeah.
Bless
Him. Bless Him, Lord. Yes. Bless your Lord. If you've come brokenhearted, give me a minute.
Amen.
Travis said, he is whatever you need.
Yes.
Amen. He'll mend that broken heart. Right? He certainly will. I'm glad tonight he's the only one who can take care of the man.
Amen.
He can do the job just exactly right in your heart and your life tonight. You just be willing, as Travis has preached to you tonight. You'd be willing to step out to come to where he is. By, he's more than willing and able tonight to reach down and get you. Get you out of that miry clay you're in. Set you up on something solid tonight.
I'm going to try to sing this song tonight.
Amen.
I might start copying, but if I don't know if they'll hear, maybe they can help me tonight.
Amen. As they sing this song tonight, would you come? Would you come tonight and feel like the Lord's knocking on your heart? Just surrendering that to Him. Be the best move you ever made.
Consider my lilies, they don't go.
Mercy.
there's great peace in that with the Lord. There certainly are. I'm glad I've got that peace there in my heart, Travis, that you've been talking about this evening. That peace that passes all understanding tonight. I'm glad I've got it.
Bless you,
I'm glad I've got that same peace in my heart tonight. I wonder if somebody's got something on your heart tonight.